Shall we start? Good morning, everyone. Welcome to today's. Welcome to listen to my presentation today. And my presentation will be based on the QRS and build an event-driven machine learning pipeline on Kubernetes. So first, a brief introduction of myself. I'm from IBM Xi'an Lab, Liu Hugang. And today, we focus on the AI Club and in the open source Kubeflow. And I'm the maintainer of many projects. And we have an American colleague who cannot be here today because of some reasons. And he is focused on AI Cloud. He is also a researcher and expert of this field. And he focuses on the model configuration. And the background of our solution, which is from the Center for Open Source Data and AI Technology team. And this team,
use
open source tools to offer the whole life cycle solution for enterprises.
And
for now, this team already offered many AI whole life cycle open source tools for enterprises. For example,
公平性或者是安全性相关的整个模块的一些工具。
The champion of human beings, chess player,
and
later we also know that Watson, IBM robot, can beat human beings winner in this competition in 2011. And this is more familiar for you, I believe. So in Chinese chess, AlphaGo beat human beings players. And about the very hot topic, deep learning, the development phase can be divided into several milestones, just like the slide show you. And in 2012, AlexNet used the deep learning and introduce the deep learning to the world. And many technologies which are widely used in this field. So the first most popular one is Facebook's face recognition in 2015. This is a very good application. And Siri also gets deep learning in 2016. And AlphaGo was very popular in 2017. For now, the deep learning, compared with a human brain, deep learning cannot be compared with a human brain.
神经网络将来且在发展的空间,
we still have a very big potential in the deep learning.
机器学习的一个
In the life cycle of the deep learning, maybe first you were focused on machine learning model and the coding of the model and how to design this model. So you can see that's the time or the energy distribution group chart. So this is in reality, actually,
时间和精力。
The time you spend in coding and the designing of the model is very little. We need to prepare a lot and collect the data and the maintenance or the management after we launch the model takes a lot of time. And this is unexpected
result.
And this is a reality. And this is a neural network design workflow. So we design this network and start another experiment and test to see whether we reach the performance standard or not. If not, then we will go to do another round. And in reality, we also have some fresh data we cannot get before. And we can use this new data to test the model. We can see that whether the model can adopt the new data or not. If yes, if no, we have to go back and go through another round. Then we will repeat this workflow again and again. And you can see this is the chart in the AI lifecycle, what kind of technology we will use. So first, the data preparation and the model, initial model and the train model, deploy model. So that's some indicative steps. And maybe we also have some different steps for some specific models. For example, we have many tools available to build as initial models. For example, Jupyter and etc. So here I want to give you an introduction of the Watson's IBM tools. And this is a very user friendly in this IBM interface. We can take some existing layer, for example, CE and CN, and some rules. You just drag in the UI, so it's a very intuitive neural network. So this is a very clear structure. After you drag and form a structure you want to have, then you can save, which can support a lot of different formats. For example, the notebook or some very popular framework you use very often. For example, TaskFlow, BellTouch, and etc. And talk about the framework. So we have many machine learning structure or framework. So different researchers have different preferences. And in this platform, we have to manage a lot of frameworks. Then we need to focus on those details. So after the training is accomplished, how can we judge this model is trained or not? Or how can we make sure the prediction from this model is very accurate? So we have to focus on four parts, four steps. So first, is this fair? Whether this model can involve different objects, just like our whole world. We have different races, and we can get some very fair scorings and treatment. And secondly, is this easy to understand? For example, some data are very difficult to interpret. And thirdly, did anyone tamper with it? So whether we can make sure the safety is reliable. And the fourth one is this accountable. So that's four dimensions we have to focus on: the fairness, explainability, and the robustness and assurance. So first, we will talk about the safety or assurance. is the model vulnerable to adversarial attacks, and this is the robustness toolbox from IBM, which is called ART.
现在比较主流的这些对抗的方法以及防御的方法
and IBM
都有实现
already realized the many mainstream
实现的
robustness toolbox and we have different ways to realize that
攻击的各种方法
which is listed in this slide
evasion
for example evasion attack
辅助性和那种 attack
And for these different attacks, we can have some counter attack measures. So whether this model is robust or not, then we also have different parameters to test that. So here we listed some parameters and we can support the training and prediction.So they have a unified model API. And about this tool, I'll give you a brief introduction. This is an ART demo. Through this link, you can click and visit our website and try it out. So this is a cat. So you can see that this is a cat. And the machine also gave a very accurate prediction, 92%. And if we have made some attacks, visually we cannot see any change, but it's already changed to an ambulance. And the credit is 19%. So we will give it some attacks.So we can address the attacks, so the robustness can be improved.
接下来的话就是说我们的这个模型是不是非常公平
whether the model is fair or not, about the fairness.
说咱们人类社会的话是普遍
存在的 In human being society, we have some discrimination.
人类社会都是不可避免
And this cannot be avoided.
社会地位啊
For example,
对不同的人
people may judge others according to the social status or appearance.
机器学习是用人类的历史数据，用人类设计的模型。
Machine learning can use some data.
一个模型，产生的一个模型。
Which can produce a model.
人类属性相关的一个技术。
And this is a technology related with human being's nature.
偏见。
So discrimination cannot be avoided.
比如来说，那就是说一个测试，就是简单说测试颜值的一个模型来说的话，如果它的那个。
This is a model which is testing the outlook or the appearance of the human beings. And if this is a model made by
Cohesion,
then if we use a picture from a Chinese very famous actor feature to test this model. Maybe this model thought this is not a handsome gentleman. So that's a discrimination. And this is, now this is AI Fairness 360. And this is an open source library. And we included more than 30 indicators into this library, and we can also use a function to produce explorable tools which can be interpreted by human beings, and we can make some adjustments.About the discrimination of the model.
And
we also have some mitigation algorithms. We can support 10 algorithms.
接近相关的算法正在实施。
We continue to involve more algorithms into this library.
当一个模型被认为说是强界性啊，还有公平性啊，等都得到验证以后，然后我们就要
Already validate the model.
部署出来以后，
fairness and
上线以后，
the robustness.
好多方面我们需要考虑。
We can deploy it.
多个版本。
And we also need to think about more details. For example, we have many versions of this model. How can we test? For example, A/B test.
对它的那个流量进行动态的调整。
How we can have a dynamic adjustments of the traffic.
还有的话就是说关于这个模型实时的性能呀
and about the real time
也要实时的监控
capacity or performance indicators we also need to have a more validation. And this is
Istio,
which is very popular recently.
Which can
guarantee the connection between different servers and the load balance and the different indicators of the different servers, and it can also monitor the login metrics, tracing.And assurance and A/B test and traffic. So we have many solutions in Istio. And next,
关于一个机器学习来说，其实它这个一个完整的
machine learning
生命周期的话是重复性迭代性是非常高的。
So it's a very iterative and repetitive, and the management process also involves a lot of tools. So we have to involve that with cloud. So why is that? Because the cloud can also support the software and the hardware, and the scalability can also be supported.So that's some advantages which is brought by KYS. Through the containers and the microservices, the maintenance is very simple. And through the KYS, we can deploy the machine learning models and through container we can have a distributed training and inference. But if we deployed the KY in this system, it's not the end of the story. We also need to consider a lot of different aspects.
最简单的话就是说，咱要是把我们这些工具啊，还有这些
For example,
然后用在我们机器学习生命周期的各个方面
apply the tools in different aspects of the machine learning and
相关的这些比如 resource and schedule 结合起来
How to be connected with the resource and the schedule scale and if every model has to handle those basic tasks, it's very difficult for us to handle them. And so we have the Kube flow. Suppose you want to deploy this model in KYS, then you have to be the expert of different aspects. For us, for a new starter, it's very difficult for you to be an expert in different aspects. So Kube flow can help you. And let me give you a brief introduction of this Kube flow. And the Kube flow can help you to separate the KYS and use Kube flow. We can do some resources management for you.
ML,
and ML,
开发人员的话，只要关注到自己的，
and the developers can only focus on the models and the machine learning.
Kube flow 的话，
so next, deep brief introduction of Kube flow.
all cloud 的一个解决方案。
Kubeflow is a solution of the AI cloud, and with a lot of modules.
核心的模块呢，可能就是
the key module is
机器学习框架的一些
the framework of the operator of the different framework of the machine learning, and for example the coffee tool and distributed training,
还有超载条约啊，有很好的支持，还有包括 notebook 呀，
and notebook
pipeline 都有很好的子项目。
We have some sub modules. Kubeflow can support all those different aspects. And Kubeflow was introduced in December 2017. And the 6.0 version will be launched next month. And this is a very simple UI about the Kubeflow UI. Maybe it's very simple, and if you have you are interested, you can check the website. And that's a brief introduction of the pipeline of Kubeflow. And we use the Kubeflow pipeline to do the machine learning pipeline solution. And through the pipeline, so this is an example. First, we acquire the data, and we train the model. Then we will have a check of the robustness and attack. After the test is passed, we will deploy that. So this is the coding of this model. After that, this is the result of the model. So through this DEG chart, you can see the relations of them. And after the pipeline train, this model, we also need the developer to trigger them manually. So if we found that the model cannot reach the expected performance, we have to run the pipeline again. Suppose the capacity of the model is not very good, or we change the data, we have to restart. Then we have to trigger the pipeline again. Then we need the data scientist and ID department to trigger that manually. But obviously, we need an automatic triggering mechanism. For example, I'm a model editor, and in the GitHub, I have written some more codings. For example, I added some AI neural layers, and now I need to push and I need to run the pipeline automatically. I don't need the manual trigger. Then this goes to the another topic I want to present you. So this is an initiative. So this is a solution. So which is divided by three parts, build, serving, and eventing. And we also have a pipeline solution, but this is already separated from the Knative. This is a separate project, so I will skip that today. So the build is very simple. How to separate the source code from some source code containers and produce a mirror and push to the register. And Knative serving. After we deploy the model, how to manage different versions and how to switch in different routes, and how to execute the network rules. It's done based on SQL, just like the first step we said. For all the things we have to use a model to address, then we can use the SQL to handle them. And the eventing, this is
we publish
the resources and to those registrators and the subscriptor, and the subscriptor can receive the event and handle them accordingly. Now, eventing can support many different things, but the source of eventing can be tailor-made according to the demand of different users. And maybe GitHub is used very often. So they can be stable step by step. And the solution is like this. And this is the realization we have done. Connective source.
GitHub 相关的那个 report 里面说这个 report 然后产生的事件，然后有哪个
get the event produced in the Kinetic, and this is the pipeline launcher's job, and the pipeline launcher can get the coding and according to the event types. So this is pull or push. And it can use the API of the pipeline launcher. Then they can start the Kubeflow pipeline. So this is the very simple modification of the previous pipeline. Because previously we have done some trainings, and the mirror of the coding are
built
before. So with that,
once GitHub 的 source code 有变动,
we have some modification, we have the push and pull in the source code, then it will trigger the pipeline automatically. Then it will rebuild the mirror and use that in the training process. We will have the source code in the future if we have more sources. For example, some image library or some warehouse. So we can also set up some event. And we can trigger that from the data acquiring. And this is a complete process with many tools and many technologies. We use KYS, is to Convertive and Kubeflow, and some open sources of IBM. For example, some awareness and the assurance tools, and some structure of the deep machine learning. So we integrated all those different tools into this life cycle. And this is the AI pipeline solution we offer. So that's all. Thank you. Any questions? Two questions. The first one, the AF360 fairness.
This
related with the cloud? No, it's not related with the cloud platform. About the algorithm of fairness, in the machine learning, This is a topic proposed in 2017, and we also have a lot of papers which address fairness and AI 360. Take some mainstream solutions and realize them. So for programmers, we can use those tools and we can use in our life cycle, so we can make our models trust. So this is open source, right? Yes. And which can, is this is can be done locally, right? Yes. It's not related with the cloud, so it can be used in AI lifecycle. And just now you mentioned the pipeline. You give an example. So maybe that's a detailed question. So I know that we need to do the test for push, but for pull, I also need to do test when I drag something. The pull. So actually this is should be the pull request. So that's an error. That's a mistake I made. So now understood. Thank you. According to my information, Kubeflow is relying on the Pro.
Pro
is
a
CI/CD. Procedure of, for example, we submit some codings which will trigger that process. So a lot of tools can be directed to GitHub. For example, some CI/CD lifecycle is realized based on the GitHub. So, if we deploy that in GitHub, is that possible? Pro
is a
KYS.
It's
used in the KYS community, and it's a CI/CD of the KYS. If we use that, we don't need to use a Pro, because a Pro is managing the codes. Then in your lifecycle management, how do we use that? So we can package the Argo, the upper layer, and we use the CI/CD to. So in this AI framework, in the AI, we don't use Pro. Pro is used in GitHub, and Argo can be deployed in your labs. Understood. And how can you get back the result once Argo is executed? How do you get the result into the interface? So for the AI, for Argo, then we can start the task, and we will also write the result of this task into the output or some literatures. And Argo, in Argo, we can read the output files. So this is some explanation with our program. So Argo cannot realize that. That's all. Thank you.
Okay,
10 minutes up. Thank you.